Hi everyone. In this video, I'm going to be talking about Planck's distribution law. In particular, we'll talk about what it is and the formula used in it. Previously, we talked about the total emissive power of a blackbody. That is, how much energy will an ideal body, which absorbs all radiation and emits all radiation, emit? If you remember, it is represented by this equation here. However, we never really discussed how we arrive at the total blackbody's emissive power formula. To achieve this formula, let's assume we only want the emissive power given off by a single wavelength, which we will denote as d lambda. So, if we are interested in the amount of radiation emitted by this infinitesimally specific wavelength, how do we know the emissive power produced by it? Well, that is where Planck's distribution law comes in. Planck's distribution law describes the emissive power of a single specific wavelength. I've written out Planck's distribution law here with all of the relevant units. It is important to note that this first term here is the monochromatic emissive power of the blackbody, or it can also be known as the spectral emissive power of the blackbody. This is what we were describing earlier. This is the emissive power of the blackbody at one single specific wavelength. So, now that we know what the emissive power of a single wavelength of our blackbody is, how do we translate that into finding the total emissive power of our blackbody? Well, couldn't we just integrate for every possible wavelength, and wouldn't that give us the total emissive power of our blackbody? If you were to carry out the integration of this integral here, you would indeed see that this statement here is true. So, that is how the formula for the total emissive power of a blackbody can be found. Through Planck's distribution law, we can do something pretty cool as well. By holding our temperature constant, we can create monochromatic or spectral distribution curves. These curves detail the monochromatic or spectral emissive power at a specific wavelength for some given temperature. After performing a few of these curves, it is clear that the peaks of all these curves trends towards lower wavelengths and higher monochromatic emissive powers for higher temperatures. However, this will be covered in the next heat transfer video, but just take note of it. Thank you for checking out this video, and I hope it helped your understanding of Planck's distribution law. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, please leave a comment down below and I will do my best to address your concerns.